Karen, well done. A really entertaining game, that, but it looked like it was going to be an easier night for you, and then it got a bit tighter.
Yeah, 2-0, and I think I was on a break of 69. I knew at that point Ollie needed a snooker, and the blue was just to sort of make sure of the frame. And, you know, 3-0 with three big breaks, you're cruising and thinking of an early night's sleep. But this game sure knows how to sort of, you know, punish you if you don't take advantage. And, you know, that's exactly what happened. I was very impressed with Ollie's safety. And, you know, I found that more or less every time I come to the table after that, I was in a snooker. So, you know, fair play to him for battling back.
Just looking back at last week, it must be a bit of a bittersweet one for you, because you showed brilliant form, but just obviously that match against Stewart, it just fell away a bit.
I think, you know, that match more or less summed up my UK Championships. Awesome in parts and then sort of bang average in other. So I just think I need to work on my concentration. I feel like the whole game is there, like I'm good under pressure, my safety's there, I'm obviously scoring very well. You know, something is missing just to sort of move on to that next level and win a major. But, you know, I'm working my way through it and trying to find it out.
One match where I'm sure your concentration won't be a problem, the Masters draw. We've kind of got the tie a lot of people wanted in Judd Trump. That'll be a fiery one, I'm sure.
Yeah, it will be a good game. We obviously had a fantastic game last year in the semi-finals. You know, hopefully I get off to a better start this year. But, you know, I'll thoroughly enjoy that match, and I'll be looking forward to it all over Christmas.
Obviously a bit of fun off the table. Judd had his comments in Northern Ireland. The fact he was saying, you know, people shouldn't put you in the bracket, that must put a bit of fire in your belly, that.
Yeah, to be honest, I think that, you know, it was sort of harsh what people were saying about him. I think, to be honest, he's had a fantastic career when you look at what he's won. He's done very well, and he gets put down a lot for not achieving so much. But, you know, as for me, I've got a very good head-to-head against him. You know, I really enjoy playing him. I don't fear him whatsoever. And I just enjoy playing him. You know, he goes for his shots, and when he misses, he leaves you plumb in. So, yeah, it'll be a good game.
He spoke about you kind of being the rivalry going forward, you and him, the kind of rivalry ahead in snooker. Is that something that you'd really relish? I suppose it gives you a little bit of added buzz in the matches against him.
Yeah, it's good going forward, especially for the game. You know, you can't rely on Ronnie Higgins and the likes of those guys forever. They're going to sort of fall away at some point. You know, they seem to be going stronger than ever, but it is inevitable that that will happen. So, you know, the game does need to look to the younger guys, and obviously me and Judd are probably those two guys that are going to do that. So, yeah, it's good for the sport, good for me. It keeps me hungry. You know, for me personally, I've got bigger fish to fry at the minute, and you know, that will come, and when it does, I'll thoroughly enjoy it.
And just the Christmas break just coming up, I suppose on this week it would be good to sign off with a really long run here.
Yeah, to be honest, I've struggled in the home nations this year. I've bombed out quite early. You know, been a bit unfortunate with some scheduling going on, but yeah, nice to get a win here. I've had a couple of good runs here in the last couple of years, so thoroughly enjoyed coming to Scotland. And, you know, Christmas is round the corner, so I've got my family here with me and gearing up for that as well.
Well, it was a really entertaining match tonight. We enjoyed it. Well done.
Thank you. Cheers.